I'll come with a round one. So here we have a very mediocre hand, but it's not a card I can really afford to mulligan in sealed. My curve starts at 3, and we have kind of a late game. We have all the lands we need, double black and double red. So I am not super happy about this hand, but I'm going to keep. Also, I did not get the chance to choose if I was on the play or on the draw. But this could very easily be a deck that I want to be on the draw. I'm not sure how fast it is in sealed. It could be quite fast in draft, so I am almost never on the draw in draft. Let's start with mountain. Doesn't really matter, actually. So yeah, I was saying that my deck could be on the draw, reason being that I have a lot of removal and I have like 3 rats basically, so I don't mind being set back and then so I can play Wrath, and the card could matter more, so I will actually consider being on the draw when I'm asked. So, I like writing down what my opponent has in his deck. I don't have a very good memory, and it's quite useful when you sideboard. Well, that's a very fortunate draw. Super happy to trade my 1-1 for your 4-1. Although he probably has something to put a counter on. Still happy to block, and then get his trick out there. Oh, well, it's actually probably the best thing you could put in this 4-1, but it's gonna die to my base. It's still pretty good. Yeah, so I'm gonna kill it. Still represent counter 3. So the green Wharf Morphs we have, there's, if we don't count in commons, we have the white one, which is the Kirin, and there's the Sandstorm Charger. I mean, it doesn't really matter now, I'm just thinking about it for later if I want to have this 2-2 or not, this manifest 2-2. Green, there's the Airy Bowmaster, which you would have probably played face up and waited a turn because it's just usually much better to play face up. And the other green card is it's the Crotic, so a huge 7 Megamorph. So if it's the 3-4 white, I don't want to block with this 2-3 next turn, but I'm already at 15, so I think I'm just going to block. And then, so we have more juice for Carb Swift, and I have 2-2 to swing back. I don't have like a double block access if he has a 3-4 because it becomes a 4-5, so I can't really block if it's this. And it could be a Kirin, and I can't block Kirin either, so I don't really have good blocks. So it turns out it's a good manifest, 4-2. He could easily block here, trade, and put 2 counters on this morph. And I don't want to lose this guy until I have formidable. So here I'm gonna probably just play this brawler and then next turn play this face up so I can block, likely block his white sandstorm charger thing. This 2-2 flyer is also annoying, but I can't really afford to have him put 2 bolster on his morph that's likely gonna morph at some point. So it's not probably, it's likely not a Kirin. Yeah, it's definitely not a Kirin. Could still be, I'm pretty sure it's the Sandstorm Charger. Or the White Morph, I'm not sure what the name is. If it is, probably happy to trade. Thinking if I want to attack with both or not. Because if I play Marshall, can he has removal for like pacifism for my Marshall? I'm taking 4. But I'm still swinging back for 4. I'm more from manifest 8-10. Yeah, it's worth it. So I'll just attack. With everything. Also he's mana short, so he's missing land drops, so it's a window for me to start being aggressive. And take good care of putting him dead. Before he actually starts putting more lands. I'm still getting used to this whole recording and even stream when I used to stream. So I apologize if I zone out sometimes because I try to think at the same time, try to play fast. And then obviously when I'm talking and I'm thinking at the same time or, you know, looking at horse tight, I might zone out. So I'm sorry about that if I do. All right. So he's not trading with Kirin, is he? What is this? It's an uncommon, probably. Which one is it? Oh, he has a Trix. Yeah. Oh, so I'm super happy actually. Super happy to trade this trick for my 2/3. It's very dangerous from him to throw this trick in my 6 red black mana. Turns out just fine for him. I couldn't be morphing this guy, but I'm losing mana if I do this, and basically I have Corpse Swift, so, and I have this guy to unmorph, so I'm not. I mean, I couldn't have morphed and played Corpse Swift, but then next turn I can't Corpse Swift and then unmanifest my 4/2. So, and I don't think the power and toughness is gonna matter. warden. Make it a 3/3. Okay, so I can make 2/2s with Corpse Swift. I can make a 4/4. I can play Corpse Swift and then manifest this on Morph. If I unmorph him, I have formidable when attacking. But if I attack with everything and he just doesn't block, I'm not in super good, not in a great situation. So I think my play might just be attack with both, attack with manifest. He blocks. No, he probably just doesn't block. I kind of want this man. I don't mind this manifest dying because I can get a 6/6 with a Corpse Swift. And I really don't want this guy to become humongous, so I will. If I attack with both, I can make a 4/4 with Corpse Swift. Corpse Swift will block Warden. Yeah, that's actually fine. Also, my 4/4 can't be pacifism, so I'll make it post combat. And it's post combat. So we could have like Sandblast, or just a trick basically, like a +3/+3 or something. I mean, +2/+2 as in tread upon, or the +2/+2, the +2/+2 that is rebound, artful maneuver. But I'm like, it's not that bad if he plays a trick, just because he's stuck on mana, so playing a trick probably means taking his whole turn. Yeah, so if he would take 6 if it doesn't block with anything. If he does block Warden on my manifest, then we would trade. Then I play Corpse Swift, and then next turn I have a huge creature. But I'm taking 4 on a backswing, maybe something like 7 if it's Sandstorm Charger. It's actually quite annoying if it's Sandstorm Charger. That would take 7 on a 4. I'm probably not racing. Hard to say. Yeah, I won't be greedy. I'll just stack with this. I think I have the advantage for late game with Corpse Swift, so I don't want to risk losing the early game. Alright, so we trade. Which is. Oh, it was sort of. Oh! Well, then I'm happy about it. I was not thinking about this. Unfortunate for you. Make a 6/6. 1, 2, 3. Oh, I forgot it can be tapped. Oh, good thing I kept this guy untapped. So I'm not in a good shape. I'm getting beat down flyers, and this guy is gonna become huge soon. So I can't sit there. Okay, my option is to draw removals or race him. If I attack with the 6/6, I can block his 5/5 with my 4/6, or block Warden actually, and then, but I take 7, I got down to 2 and lose to a fire beat down next turn. Unless I draw removal. If I attack with a 4/6, he just blocks, and I can't sit there. So if I attack for 6, at least I have kill him in 2 turns. But unfortunately, I think I have to attack. I can't just sit there. He also has 2 cards in his hand that are probably spells, since he missed land drops. And he has his 6th, which means this guy is going to be very huge next turn. The good thing is that he might not attack with everything if he has because he has mana for this. Oh shit. Guy comes into play tapped. 9/11, yeah. Fortunate. Tread upon Hunt the Weak. Yeah, that was the 5/5 Stampeding Elk. And the Warden. So, he's playing green-white, so we're going to sideboard this self-inflicted wound. He has different size of creatures. Most of them are big, which means there's not that many cards we could board in against that, I guess. This 2/5 is even too small because he has Flyer, Warden, a 5/5 for 5. He even has the 2/2 pump on the Weak. He has a thing that destroys a artifact or enchantment, the Aenox Surrealist. So. Born in this self-inflicted wound. This rupture, seismic rupture, does not seem to be very good against what I saw. I wouldn't mind boarding it out and boarding it back if I see something. If I see a reason to board it for game 3. I can't say that any of my creatures' sizes match bad against my opponents, just because I haven't seen many, and most of them were like big, so I wouldn't mind trading. He has a 4/1/3/3. I'd probably like to board that card out. I think it's good against like 2/2s and 3/2s and 4/2s, but likely not against green white. This edict is probably better. As long as he doesn't have many small creatures, which we haven't seen yet. So let's try that. It's also one more in 3 mana instant sorcery that we born in. Instead of the Rapture for Volcanic Vision. Do I want to play last? I think I'm going to play last. We'll try this. This hand is, again, not great. It's not great, but this is on the draw. If we just play a bunch of these four power guys, this hand was actually would be probably better to play, except for the fact that we need a land or two even. I feel like this could be dangerous. We do have 9 swamps, and we have 15 draws that are lands, and we have Twin Bolt, has 2 drop. So, yeah, it's statistically wise, it's good. We have 33 cards in our deck. We have at least 16 hits. So we have one each 2 drops draw steps, and we have 3 draw steps before we start doing something. So I'm gonna keep this on the draw. Retrospectively, I would probably ship on the play just because I have like 2 draw steps basically. Oh, turns out well. Although this was a mulligan to, this was a 7 card hand, so I'm usually mulligan more when it's 7 and 6. Like if it was 6 minus like the dragon or something, or even like a 4 drop, I would stack keep. But on 7, I could have tried a better hand. Do I want to trade with my 2/3 or edict them? The problem is that I want to trade, but it might just not happen. You might just not want to trade. But he's likely not going to play a worse creature after. But I don't really have another window because I'm going to start playing 4 drops. So I am going to kill it. Hopefully he puts something on it. So we saw the Survivalist, which becomes a 3/2. We drew a Cobra. He missed his land drop, so I'm going to try to be more aggressive. And I'm going to play this 4/2, I believe. Because I'm going to play another 4 power next turn, and it's going to be formidable. I want to play this 4/3. I want to play 4/2 because I'm not happy about trading with a 2/3. So I have to be aware of tricks here. But you can only have so many, so you can only play one really this turn. And if it doesn't have it, I am likely risking too much by letting him draw lands. So the question is, I want to play this 4-2 Aced, a Cobra, I want to dash my 2-3 and then bathe something. If I play my 4-2 Aced, he's going to trade with the Morph. Put the Artisan on my 4-2 Outrider, and then maybe play a trick that I'm left with a 4-3 and he has a 2-3. And it took a bunch of damage. I mean, if I don't play this 4-2, he's gonna like might maybe double block with the Morph and Artisan on my Outrider. Yeah, I think I'm gonna play this. Dashing my 2-3 and then playing Bathe, it's not bad. But it's only killing the Morph, which only trades well with my Chaman. Because if he has the pump spell as I'm playing around, well, he's just going to protect the Artisan. But then I can't attack with anything. Because I'm not really happy to trade there. So I'm just losing time. I think this is the best line of play if he does not have the pump spell. And I think it's better to not play around this pump spell at this point. I'm just going to give him too much time. I have enough juice anyway. To not worry about trading, and he has to trick probably. But as I said, I don't think I can afford just sitting there and waiting. I have enough juice. Oh, I also forgot that. Oh, I forgot this. I said this card wouldn't do anything because of the teamer ability, but I forgot it did that. Well then my play was probably bad. I should have bathed the 2-2 then. My bad. Should probably still win. Yeah. His morph was the curing. That's good to note. Jamoka, Monument, and Grace Blade, Artisan. So this is a 7-8. It's not flying. Play Cobra and this guy. So this is like the really bad overrun. Bolster X. I'll write it down in case I have to read it later. Sunbringer, Torch, Touch. Bolster X, number of cards in your hand. Each creature control of the ball, you can trample. Okay, it's pretty bad. I mean, it's good at just bolstering for 4 mana. I like all the cards that bolster on your creatures. Because they make a 1, like, hell of a threat early. So the card's probably fine. But the overrun ability on it is mediocre. Still good to know that you could give trample all of his board if they have counters. So the size of his creatures are still... big enough for me to not want this Pyroclasm or Whip Flare, should I say? No, what's the card? the rough tumble. I don't know which one of the two is the two damage to each non-flying, but you know what I mean. This, I'm not sure if this section is good, but I'm gonna try it. So do I want this 3-3-4-4 instead? It's quite mediocre that it dies to a survivalist. So does Corpse Weft, but it's probably more devastating. Oh, this is a 1-6. I thought this was on 1-5. This 1-6 blocks a lot of things. I might want that. I don't think I have time to, especially on the draw, I don't think I have time to do stuff with the executioner. But this is a zombie. It's a zombie. Combos. This is a zombie too. So is this. It's actually relevant. I did not look at it because I looked it up before how many zombies were in the set, and there was just not many. So I just ruled it out as being a relevant ability, but it actually is. This and is fine again. Not insane, but it's good. So far I have not drawn many of my removals, which are usually great against green-white decks. If I stop drawing lands, this draw step should be fine. No more lands. The rest of the game, I'll be fine. Play this 4-2, this 4-1. I'm not blocking because I know most of these creatures wouldn't mind trading with my 4. I wouldn't mind trading my 4-1 for them, and I have the 4-2 Outrider. And I mean, just in a vacuum, I'm racing them if we'd have nothing. Which he does. I'm not disappointed that he uses this removal. What if this 4-2 to be mana efficient? Or I could play this 2-3 and just trade. Which is not bad, because next turn I can make a 4-4. And then this guy would be formidable a couple turns later. That Jamoka's command. Ouch. I've not drawn any of my wrath or removal, I think, in a match. It's unfortunate. Curse of Fate now. I mean, it's a good thing because he's not expecting them. But if I don't draw them, it's not doing much. And Corpse Whip now. I actually forgot this card put zombies tapped. It's a lot worse than I thought. Could make a 4/4. It's pretty bad. He's gonna regenerate this soon. If I make a 4/4, I take 7, I'm going down to 6. And next turn, I don't have that many good blocks. So I should just play this 4/2, hope he has nothing, and hope he has nothing to make this able to regenerate. Or play this guy, block, manifest. And then I can double block this 3/5 next turn. Or make a 6/6. Yeah, let's do this. Then I can play Corpse Weft, and then next turn make a 6/6, then play a 4/2. Yeah, that's better. I mean, I think Corpse Weft, even though it's worse than I thought, it's probably good in my deck because of Executioner and because I have Curse of Fate, which sometimes could just kill some of my creatures, and then I can never lose it if I had Corpse Whip in play. I can manifest my Curse of Fate. Oh, that's actually insane. Shit, that's all huge creatures. Okay. So, I have to play it faster. So if I morph this guy, it's gonna be 4/6. I can eat the Kushuk, take 7. Or I could play a 4/2. Block the Kushuk. Make an 8/8. Take 7 and go on 3. Difference is I have a guy untapped for next turn or not. But I have Outrider. This gives me, playing Outrider gives me one more guy on the board right now. Possible I should have attacked first, but he might just not block. I have 2 damage free because I'm not blocking. But then again, if he has removal, my Outrider. Oh, he has Underweak? Fuck. Oh, he has Underweak. Damn it. But I can still block the 4/6. Which is good news. I got a 1. I need to draw a creature. I absolutely need to draw a creature. I'm gonna make a 6/6. Nice. make a 4-4. Four, 4-4 four is not exciting because it just get blocked by that or trade, doesn't even trade. But I cannot afford to just, oh well. This doesn't do anything so far because I'm not drawing spells. Yeah, I have no good attacks. So play this land pass. Yeah, if I could draw a removal for this crew shot, it would be insane because I would likely be able to kill this card bearer. I have to block and make a 2-2. Faster. Nice. Okay, I have no time. I can't really just sit there, so I'm going to start attacking. If he has removal, he has removal. It's still probably very bad to do what I did if he has removal. Or this. Would it have mattered? Oh yes, it would have. Oh well, punished. 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 Yeah, if I just untap my two, I block, I untap with my things, I can kill his 3-3, then have Bathe and Dragonfire in my hand. I have a lot of turns. That was really bad. And I was drawing this. Damn it. Alright. So, see you for round 2, hopefully. A little better.